Who is or was Gurdjieff?
Well, it's hard to reduce any human being to the statement of who are they. But it's interesting to note that in his major work, his major written work, he signed in the very beginning his name as Gurdjieff, George Gurdjieff. He called himself a teacher of dance, which is very significant from the point of view of you being here to ask me about the Gurdjieff dances. Mm-hmm. So Gurdjieff was a teacher of dance. He was a man who was deeply interested in why human beings exist, what might be their purpose, what is the purpose of life, not just individual life, but the life on the planet and the life of human beings. And he followed this question as an aim, a real aim in his life, for his whole life. And that appears by those who knew him to have created a force inside of him, and that force, he traveled, he searched, he appears to have found answers to his questions, and then he experimented and worked with people to develop a way of working, a way of being in life. Particularly, he worked with Western people and seems to have been particularly interested in how he could help Western people to achieve their own aims, the fulfillment of life, if they wished to do so.
I read that he was searching for old dances, and then he founded, on the base of old dances, he founded a special movement. Is this correct?
I think it's very close to correct. He was searching, and certainly in his search, he found brotherhoods, monasteries, where people were working for what you might call spiritual development or personal development, and they were using dances, they were using movements, they were using inner exercises, they were using certain kinds of work with the body that required specific movements. And he himself brought many of these back with him to the West and also developed his own. He was certainly a creative genius when it came to the field of dance, movement, and music. Much of the music used for the movements is based on melodies that he not only remembered, but that he also developed for the dances.
And he was searching in which cultures he was searching?
Central Asia, mm-hmm. The Middle East. There are reports he went as far as Tibet, mm-hmm. Certainly North Africa, around Egypt, Persia.
Mm-hmm. And do you know why he was so interested in the dance? Especially in the movement?
I can't honestly say he was so interested in dance, but he was interested in human transformation, and he saw that through dance, through movement, this was possible in very unique ways.
Mm-hmm. He saw it in the monasteries.
That's what he reports, yes, that he saw people dancing in the monasteries, working in certain ways with their bodies, with their attention.
And these monasteries and the movement, were these secret monasteries, or was this open culture?
It is reported again by Gurdjieff, or in the books, that they were ancient monasteries. Many were secret, I suppose, and many of them disappeared. He did much of his searching before the First World War, And as many of us know, after the First World War, there were many changes out there and in those areas, and places just disappeared.
So he is, one can say, an archaeologist of movements. Can one say this also?
Ein Archäologe wie ein Archäologe, der Bewegungen quasi gesammelt hat, wie ein anderer Archäologe.
I think that would be vague. Mm-hmm. What was the word you used?
Archaeologist
of movement. I would say he was an archaeologist of the development of human potential and how the human body works and what it might be used to do.
And the movements, for instance, you are presenting in your workshops, are the movements Gurdjieff has created. Is it like that?
Yes.
Oh. And how do you know that?
How do I know that?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I learned them from people who learned them from Gurdjieff, mm-hmm. and there's been a strong movement in the Gurdjieff movement to try to keep the dances authentic as people learn them, and I try to keep them authentic as I learn them from the people who learn them from Gurdjieff. And I've worked with people who were direct students of Gurdjieff and who had their notes and their experiences. This question of authenticity, of course, everything changes immediately as soon as it passes from one person to another. But there has been a very big effort in order to try to maintain both the inner working of the movements, how one works inwardly when one is doing the movements, as well as the outer movements. And there have been many ways of writing them down. Groups have studied them for years. They have been preserved. It's an oral transmission.
You said before that there is healing is not enough for the movements. It's a transformation is happening. But can you explain for people who haven't seen it? What do you mean by that?
I'm not sure about your question. I didn't say healing is not enough.
I said I made a program about the healing of plants, and the Gurdjieff movement, they don't heal, they transform.
We are not directly interested in healing, although in order to become a real human being, one must go through healing processes and sometimes very definite stages of healing. Gurdjieff's work is concerned with what he called the harmonious development of the human being, trying to bring into harmony and into balance different centers in the body. And of course, you can look at illness or sickness as the body being out of balance in its chemistry, in its psychology, in its physiology, and therefore if your aim is to bring the body into balance, into harmony, then it's quite natural and that a healing will take place. But the aim of the Gurdjieff movements and the aim of the dances that we do is what we call transformation. And healing may, not necessarily, but may follow from that. From my own experience, there is a great potential for healing, but it has not been directly explored, both psychological as well as physiological healing. There's a great potential in the dances, in the work of the movements, but it hasn't been directly explored, and it could be, and there's no reason why it could not be.
And transformation has been explored?
Yes.
How?
But then the question is, what do you mean by transformation? Because it's one of these words which... I know, but...
It's not so interesting in this case. Because the audience is not so interesting, in my opinion.
To talk about that, you have to talk about what we believe or what we might put out there as a hypothesis about human existence. that naturally human beings grow to a certain level or a certain way. Nature is interested in human beings reproducing themselves and maintaining themselves on the planet. This is not hard to believe. You can look around and see that all nature is interconnected, and all nature in a very simple way produces different qualities of energy, whether you're talking about plants or animals or human beings. So from the natural point of view of a human being, we would say nature is interested in having a healthy human being who makes babies, doesn't destroy the world, and dies and goes on. I can't speak for all spiritual traditions, but I believe that probably all spiritual traditions say there is another purpose or reason for human existence. And Gurdjieff would say that, yes, there is, that another reason for human existence is to participate with nature or to participate with God in the further evolution or development of the planet. And so we would look at transformation as that process of further developing our human potential and as participating in the greater cosmological scheme, if you want to call it, participating in that in a very specific way.
But how can movements participate in this process?
Well, the movements or the dances are not an end in themselves. They are a means. They are techniques. They are ways of working with the body so that this transformation, so that this participation can take place. You can say there are two definite purposes of the movements for people who work with them, one being this harmonious development of the body. And we still haven't spoken about exactly what that means from Gurdjieff's point of view. The other is to receive or collect energy from, we would say, outside the planet, that all life is not just organisms that produce energies, but they can receive vibrations from the sun and even from further away, from outside the solar system, and human beings can receive them in a special way. And groups of human beings can receive them in a special way. So some of the movements have for us a very definite ritual quality. And it is very definitely a group ritual, a group dance. And I've experienced this in my own work with myself in a movements group about how working at certain kinds of movements or dances in a certain way can open the group up to feeling that something and sensing that they are receiving something. Yeah, it's a good idea. I mean, it sounds nice, but that's basically one that we would say is the purpose of this.
And for instance, there this is very similar to a shamanistic ritual also. Mm-hmm. What is the difference from your point of view?
Well, I don't know anything about shamanistic rituals, very little, so it would be hard for me to say what the difference is. Okay. But let me bring in one thing which we haven't spoken of. Mm-hmm. The essence of the Gurdjieff work and also of the work of the movements is what happens when you bring your attention inside your body. The instrument that we work with, you can say the two instruments we work with, one is the body and the other is attention. And what takes place when I bring my attention inside my body? What takes place when I divide my attention between energy or experiences inside my body and the other people in the dance. This creates a flow of energy both inside the body and between people. So I don't know if that's similar to shamanistic work or shamanistic healing. It's, in some ways it seems to me, I don't know. But this is what we're doing on the inside. What you see of the Gurdjieff dances on the outside is the outside. You might feel something. Many people do if the people who are performing them or working with them know the inner workings. People might begin to feel a certain quality of energy in the air.
And the group is a very important in the Gurdjieff movement. One cannot do it without the group, the movement.
You can certainly practice the inner exercises, the inner work of transformation, alone, when you're walking down the street. There's many aspects of this inner work that you can practice. In the movements, in the dances, it certainly is a group process. And we never perform them individually or even teach them for individuals to perform individually, but for groups of people to work together. The group is not an artificial construct. There are loners in the world, but there's no way that you can escape interaction with other people. In fact, you cannot become even a natural human being without having an interaction with your parents or with some kind of community or society. And this awareness of others, this being in the world with others, is a very important part of this work. And so the dances give us an opportunity to experience that specifically with many people, so that we can take that experience from the group experience and begin to use it honestly and effectively in life, because there are other people in life.
Mm-hmm. And if one, you say the movement, if you look from the outside, there are just movements. But even there's an audience and they haven't seen the movement. Mm-hmm. Yeah? So it's perhaps important to explain a little bit the movement only from the outside.
I'm not sure how there are so many different postures or gestures or ways of being, but I would like to describe, if you have observed a performance of the Gurdjieff movements or experienced the Gurdjieff movements, the first thing you might notice is that maybe all of the movements, except for a few, well, many of the movements begin with a normal, natural, standing posture. A posture we human beings take for granted, but which is an incredibly unique posture. In nature, there are no other animals that adopt, in their final level of development, this posture of standing on 2 feet in this upright position. Mm-hmm. And many of the movements begin from that position, that posture, and return to it at the end. And in between, there is a journey, an individual journey and a journey of the group that manifests in different ways depending on which movement we're working with.
But from the outside, it does look like a choreography.
It's very much choreographed. Gurdjieff very definitely choreographed the movements to have specific effects on people. So it's very choreographed, but many of them are very different in their choreography. So the Gurdjieff Rockettes. You know the Rockettes on stage in New York Radio City? Yeah, the Gurdjieff Rockettes. Except we spend more time with what's going on inside than with what's going on outside. Because
one has to learn the correct movement.
I'm not sure learning is the right word, although many people will put it that way. One has to come to the correct movement. Just as one has come to this posture of standing, you didn't learn how to stand.
Yeah, but I have to make this movement like that.
Yeah.
I have to make it like that and like that.
You might make it like that to start with. And then you learn about the energy that fills up the body.
Yeah.
And then you have the aim to have it like this, so that energy can help you achieve the aim. Mm. But you can also make it like that, and then it just becomes a stiff stick of an arm rather than an arm filled with life. Mm. And for your own experience, those two things are very different.
Mm.
Part of the movements and the gestures is to relax and let go of the tensions inside the body and to allow the life of the body, the life that we work with our attention, to expand and grow inside the body and to fill up the arm to take the gesture that you want. So you could say that's learning the gesture. I don't like to use that language, because it puts too much emphasis on the gesture. Because the gesture is the result of where and what you wish your body to do and the interactivity of your attention with the energy inside your arm and inside your body that fills it up. Just like you as a human being, this was not developed from the outside. This is the life inside your body filling it up and manifesting it as Nora. And how that manifests is changeable depending on how Nora develops her own energy, develops her own what we would call inner life, nurtures it, feeds it, allows it to grow and expand and become what she wishes it to be. All of that is inside stuff. So I emphasize that because it's real learning. But many people mistake dance, and in particular the Gurdjieff dances, for making the body do what you want it to do. It's really an invitation to the life inside the body to manifest through the body into a gesture that we wish to have.